The today's video about QFTest features shows how to use QFTest to drive UI-based load tests. UI-based load tests generate the load of the system via the graphical user interface, so you can monitor the whole system and all effects from the server to the end user. This approach enables you to observe issues like end-to-end times or user acceptance times. It's possible to combine UI-based load tests with protocol-based load tests in order to reduce required resources or to simplify scaling of the generated system load. A typical architecture of a UI-based load testing scenario with QFTest could look like shown here. On the left, there is the controller system of the load test execution. This system manages the test execution on the involved test systems. In the center, there is the block of test clients. Here we see various test systems which are used to generate the system load. On those systems, the system under test and QFTest need to be installed, and the test scenarios using the UI will be performed there. All measurements taken from the test system itself, like end-to-end times and any other test system-based logging, can be found there. Finally, on the right, there is a block, SUT server, which stands for application servers involved in the architecture of the system under test. Protocol-based load tests typically take their measurements from those servers. To perform those measurements, third-party software is required. The communication between the controller system and the test system is established by the QFTest daemon. QFTest provides a demo project for such a UI-based load testing scenario, testing the QFTest demo application of the car configurator. The demo project is located in the load testing folder in the QFTest demo folder. The demo project contains three test suites. The test suite Daemon Controller two-faces QFT represents the controlling and management test suite for the test execution on multiple test systems. There are four main nodes in that test suite. The test case initialization performs necessary preparation steps of the test execution, like creating test data. The test set launch phase contains setup steps which need to be performed on the test systems in order to launch the application, and the steps to launch the application itself, as well as a couple of warm-up steps if required. The test set test phase contains real test cases which perform the measurements now and which really create the system load. The last test case, cleanup, contains necessary post-execution steps like stopping the tested applications after executing the tests. The test set test phase can be copied as many times you need to cover the planned test phases of your load testing scenario. The participating test systems and their roles in this scenario should be configured in the already provided Excel file systems.xlsx, which can be found in the sample project as well. So it's possible to set up a scenario having various systems acting in different roles, like a role to execute regular user tests and a second role acting as an observer or an admin. The utilized tests of those roles can be configured in the controller test suite in the respective test phase. The test suite car config load testing contains the implemented test cases which will be executed during the test phases. Monitoring points for the end-to-end times will be marked by setting the @transactionDoc tag in the command attribute of the node to measure. In this example, the duration of the sequence open vehicles is measured, which represents the end-to-end time which takes the application from the click of the menu item to open the dialog till the dialog finally appears. The measurement is implemented using the so-called test run listener API of QFTest, which enables you to inject arbitrary monitoring points to your code. More on that can be found in the scripting videos and chapters in the manual. The third test suite, Check for Running Daemons QFT, is a simple verification test suite which contains steps to check whether all test systems are up and running and ready to start your load testing scenario. As a result of the test execution, a flat CSV file is generated containing the specific measurements. That file is generated for every involved test system, so you can decide to merge those files into one huge file or to upload them individually to dedicated analyzation tools. As the measurements are taken by the test run listener API of QFTest, the content and structure of the file can be adapted to any desired structure. You might consider to write those results directly into a database or forward them via a web service as well. Of course, you can also implement further scripts directly in your QFTest suites, which evaluate or merge the test results inside QFTest. Let's go into medias res now and let's take a look at a real example. The shown demo project is located in the load testing folder in the QFTest demo folder. You should copy that directory to a folder where you have write permissions before you start, so all of your modifications can be saved later. The test suite car configurator load testing contains the implemented test cases which should be executed on the test systems. In our case, we test the car configurator demo application and focus on measuring user acceptance times of dedicated steps like creating a vehicle in the car configurator. The first test case, launcher test case, contains sequences and steps to start the car configurator and a few warm-up steps. The test set vehicle test contains various test cases of creating a vehicle. Steps to measure a user acceptance times are packed into sequences, and those sequences are marked by the keyword @transaction plus an arbitrary name to identify that monitoring point in the log files later. So in this case, we have a transaction open vehicles, which measures the sequence to open the vehicle dialog, meaning we measure the time, how long it takes the application to open a dialog from clicking a menu item till the dialog appears. A second monitoring point in this test case is the sequence closing dialog, which is actually again marked by a transaction and then the name close vehicles to identify that monitoring point in the log file. And this monitoring point measures the time, how long it takes to close the dialog, meaning from the click to close the dialog till the dialog really disappears. Those two sequences have been identified as monitoring points because once you open and or close the application, a client-server communication in the application's architecture is being performed. The second test case is more or less similar to the first one, which also contains two monitoring points, open the dialog and closing the dialog. The third test case is more or less the same, but it contains one more server script showing a synchronization point which can be used to synchronize the test execution of all involved test systems. So the test systems will stop till all test systems can reach that particular synchronization point, and once all of the systems have reached that point, then the test execution will be proceeded again. And this is happening via the call of RC sync threads in that server script. My test scenario should run on two test systems. In order to configure the load testing scenario to use those two systems, I have to open the systems XLS file, which is part of the load testing folder as well. Every row in that Excel file specifies one test system, which could be part of our load testing scenario. In row 2, we see the first system, in row 3, we see the second system, and so on. In the first column, we define the name of the test system or the IP address of the test system. I run the tests on my local machine now, I specify localhost there. In the second column, I define the port number, which is used to communicate between the system and our controller system, because the QFTest daemon requires a network communication via a dedicated port. In the third column, I can define the role which my test system actually acts in my load testing scenario. Here I specified role 1, which stands actually for a regular user. Of course, I could also think about defining a role like an operator role, an observer role, or a disturber role, and so on. In the fourth column, exec, I can specify whether that particular system should take part in my next test run. If an X is specified there, the test system will take part in the next test run. If the cell is empty, like in row number 3, then the system won't take part in the test run. The remaining variables like name, price, and comment, and so on, they are just used by the test cases itself, so that's internal test data required by the test cases. As our test cases deal with creating vehicles, we have specified the name and the price of the vehicle to create there. As already mentioned, row number 3 is actually the next test system which won't take part in the test execution. And in row number 4, we find the second test system which will take part on the test run because we have an X here. And because I run that test system on my local host as well, I have to define a different port in my Excel file. Please note that in real life it's recommended to run test cases on different test systems, at least on different UI containers. That's because multiple UIs on the same UI container or on the same screen could disturb each other. So please think about using virtual systems or Docker images in implementing your load testing scenario. As next step, I need to launch the QFTest daemon for each test system. So in my case, I need to launch it twice. I have already prepared 2 shell scripts for that purpose. Let me open one of them. Here we see that the script contains a command line to start the QFTest daemon as described in the QFTest manual using a dedicated port. In order to start the daemons now, let me simply double-click the scripts. Depending on the configuration of your systems, you might see the daemon processes running, like in my case, or you just see them running in the background. As the test systems are ready, let me open the Management Test Suite Daemon Controller Two-Faces QFT from the Load Testing folder. At the Test Suite node, it's possible to configure global variables like the location of the log files, so the log files of the QFTest execution as well as the controller execution will be logged to those directories. We can also specify the path to our systems Excel, and we can also specify a couple of timeouts in order to manage the execution of our test phases. The present demo project contains 2 test phases, the launcher test phase, which is about of starting the car config demo application and doing one warm-up step, and the real test phase, which is actually performing the measurement test cases, which we have seen before. And inside that test phase, there is an if node evaluating the role variable coming from the Excel file. So whenever we want to introduce another role, we actually add an else if node there, and using a set variable specifies the path to the test suite plus the test case which needs to be executed for that particular role. In my case, everything is fine, so I can select the test suite now and start the test execution. As you can see, both test applications have been started now, so let's wait for the test execution or for the real test phase to be executed. The vehicles have also been created and the test run reached the synchronization point, so after a couple of seconds the applications will be closed. Now the tests are terminated, so let's take a look at the created log files. So first take a look at the log files of the daemon controller suite. You can find the log folder in the QFTest log file folder, and there is a load test logs folder being created. Inside that load test logs folder, you have 2 folders, one logs and daemon controller. One logs contain another directory having the name as the timestamp of the current execution. And there we see the QFTest log files for each phase and for each system. And in the daemon controller suite, we see again a folder having the timestamp as its name, and then the log file of the daemon controller, so of the test execution management test suite. The log files of the test execution on the test systems, so all the log files containing the measurements which we are interested in, can be found in the QFTest app data folder on the test systems. And there is again a folder having the timestamp in its name. And there you find a CSV file containing the measurements. In my case, I have two files there because I have started two tests on the same system. And in those files, you see the measurement points like open vehicles, closed vehicles, how long it takes in milliseconds, and then the current timestamp and the state whether the execution was okay or not. And all of those log files from the individual test systems can be collected now and merged to a huge file. And this can happen via custom scripts implemented by your admins or scripts implemented inside QFTest. Or you modify the test run listener, which is part of the car config load test in QFT, in order to write the measurements directly to a database or to upload them to an analyzation and evaluation tool via a web service or whatever means of evaluation you want to use in your project. The shown scenario, as well as the description of the demo project, can be found in the QF test manual in the chapter Performing UI-based Load Tests. UI-based load tests measuring end-to-end times or the user acceptance time can easily be implemented with QF test. Nevertheless, some preparation time is definitely required to adapt the provided demo project to your needs and to implement the needed test cases. You should also think about how to evaluate the test results and measurements afterwards. You can find another approach of performing load tests with QFTest in the demo video of using QFTest together with the load testing tool NeoLoad at this channel. UI-based load testing is a really exciting area of UI testing. Don't miss to use QFTest for such projects.